Good morning. Good morning once again, Father God. Good morning, O Holy Spirit. And good and blessed morning po sa ating lahat. I am very blessed this morning. I am very blessed this morning. Masayang-masaya po ako ngayong umagang ito. Si nandito ang aking kaibigan. Si Lucy. Wow, ilang taon, no? Ilang taon na nahanap ko si Lucy sa Farnborough, hindi ko makita. When was the last time na nagkita tayo? Tagal, ano? 2014? Barrio Fiesta ba yun? 2011 ba? Wow. Kababata ko si Lucy, kasama ko siya sa college. And nakita ko din siya sa Israel. And nakita ko siya rito sa UK few occasions. Pero yun nga, talagang the Lord has made this day blessed. Amen po. Na bendisyon kami nga ako, makapasyar ka kanyami, Lucy niya. Hallelujah. And we know and we do believe by faith na this is only the beginning. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The God of revival is in this place. Amen. Wala po tayong ibang Panginoon na pinagsisilbihan. Wala po tayong ibang Panginoon na sinasamba kundi ang God of revival. Amen po. Amen. So, Lucy, it's the God of revival that allows me to stand here in front. Siguro sabi ni Lucy, siguro, ito ba yung kaklasiko dati na, ano? Ito ba yung kaklasiko dati na, siguro kung bibigyan natin si Lucy ng pagkakataon to ibigay lahat yung basura na kung ano yung sino ako. Kung yung basura na kung sino ako, siguro mapupuno natin lahat yung mga bin na nandyan. So, Lucy, it's only the God of revival that allows me to stand in here. Amen? Church, why don't we ipadama natin kay Lucy yung kung paano mag-welcome ang mga anak ng Panginoon. Sige, if you wanna go and makipagkamay sa kanya, welcome, 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 no, welcome, welcome, welcome. We are blessed and we are glad that you are able to come to the house of the Lord, that you are able to worship and honor the Lord with us today. Sige, manalangin po tayo. Hallelujah. Lord, you are the God of revival. And you are the God of this place. You are the God of your people. And thank you because you are in this place today. You are our God of revival. Truly indeed, Father God, na ikaw lamang po yung may kakayahan. Truly indeed that you are the only reason that we are able to come, that we are able to gather, that we are able to stand, O God. Ikaw po lamang yung rason, Lord, that we are able to sit down as well and reason and receive from you. Kaya Lord, once again, we continue to humble ourselves down unto you. We continue na magpakumbaba sa iyo. We continue to ask for your forgiveness and any unrepented sin, patawarin mo po kami, Lord. Pakalinisin, pakabanalin mo po kami upang sa ganun, Father God, ay malaya kang makakilos, malaya kang maipamalas, O Lord God, ang iyong pagkatao, kung sino ka po talaga, Father God. And Lord, we pray na give us that receptive heart, give us that spirit, O Lord God, upang hindi lamang po kami magkasya na pakinggan, makinig sa iyong mensahe, kundi Father God, i-put that message alongside in line with us, Father God. Lord, upang sa ganun, mailagay po namin yung mensahe alongside our buhay, Father God. If, kumbaga, Lord, if they fit together, Father God. At Lord, kung merong mang area sa aming buhay na that can be improved, na pwedeng mabago, na pwedeng palitan, Lord, with your word, with your power, Father God, with your grace and mercy, kumilos ka po, Panginoon. Maraming salamat, Lord. As for your servant, nagpapatuloy po akong nagpapakumbaba and I continue to ask, Lord, that you cover me with your most precious blood so that I will be able, Father God, na magampanan kung ano man po, Lord, yung gagampanan, Lord God, na inialay or you have allowed me, Father God, na magampanan ngayong araw na to, O Diyos. Ito po ang aming samot dalangin sa iyong pangalan. Amen. Hallelujah. The God of revival. Amen. Why don't we declare that the God of revival is in this place? Amen? The God of revival is in this place. And this place, mga kapatid, this place is the place of worship, no? This place is His dwelling. Amen po. So, I have a series of question in here. May mga series po ako ng katanungan dito para hindi po tayo ma-board, tayo antukin, and I want us to participate as well. Amen. I want us to participate either audibly or in our heart and in our mind. Amen po, no? So first question is, what is a church? What is a church, my dear brothers and sisters? The biblical definition of the church is the body of Christ. Amen po. The biblical definition of the church are the people, the believer with a common faith. And ano yung faith natin na yan? With a common faith to our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen po. Now when we talk about the church, it is us and it is not this building. Amen. So when we talk about a church, it is us, yung mga tao po that gathers, yung mga tao that profess the same faith in our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. So whether we are gathering here today or we are gathering in someone else's house during the week, that is a church because that is the gathering of the Lord's people. Amen, church? What is a place of worship? What is a house of worship? Or in here, what is God's dwelling? No? What is the house of God? Amen? That is the place where the church comes and gather. Amen po. That is the place where the church comes and gather. Gather to do what? Gather to worship. Amen. Kaya nga sinasabi natin na the place of worship. Kaya nga sinasabi natin, mga kapatid, na the house of worship. Because that is the place where we come to worship. Amen po. And when we say worship, ano po yung, what do we mean kung sabi natin worship? Worship encompasses prayers. Worship encompasses the exhortation that we give. Worship encompasses the prayers that we offer to the Lord for the life of our children. Worship encompasses yung ating giving, the tithes and offering. Worship encompasses our praise, yung singing, yung music. Worship encompasses serving others, mga kapatid. Worship encompasses yung ating scriptural reading. Worship encompasses message. Worship encompasses 1 Corinthians 10:31. Whatever it is that we are doing, as long as we do that in a manner that glorifies the Lord, that is worship. Amen. Even this very fact, moving of this camera and moving of this stand in here, if you do that in a manner that glorifies the Lord, we consider that worship. Amen, church? Hallelujah. So the question now is, why do we come to the place of worship? Why do we gather here? Why do we come here on a Sunday? Why do we gather during the week and other people's household? Why do we gather online via Zoom or Messenger during the week, mga kapatid? There should be no other reason but to worship. Wala po sanang ibang rason but to worship. Amen? In Matthew chapter 21, verses 12 to 13, it says in here, this is the time. Who can remember this in their heart? Matthew 21, 12 to 13. This is the time when Jesus cleansed the temple. The temple being the house of worship. The temple being the place of worship. Amen po. And Jesus entered the temple and drove out all who sold and bought in the temple, and he overturned the tables
of the money changers and the seats of those who sold pigeons. And he said to them, it is written in Isaiah 56:7 that my house shall be called a house of prayer. It is written that this house of worship, that this place of worship shall be called a house of prayer, sabi ng Panginoon. But you make it a den of thieves. Another translation, you made it a den of robbers. So my dear brothers and sisters, Jesus said, my house should be a place where you come and worship. Again, when we say worship, sabi natin, everything that we do, prayer, exhortation, lahat, alam po natin yun. Amen po. But Jesus said, my house should be called a house of prayer, but you make it in a den of thieves, a house of robbers. Ano po yung sinasabi sa atin ng Panginoon? Ano po yung sinasabi ng Panginoon? Ito yung purpose ng aking tahanan, pero ito yung ginagawa nyo sa aking tahanan. Ibig sabihin, there is a misuse. Amen. There is a misuse. You misuse the house of the Lord. You misuse the house of worship. You misuse the place of worship where you ought to come and worship, pero you come and you do other things. You misuse the house of the Lord. Sabi niya rito, mga kapatid. Amen? You are using it contrary to the purpose. There is a misuse. Again, my dear brothers and sisters, magpapasintabi po ako. Amen? Magpapasintabi po ako. This message is not for an individual person. Amen. Itong mensahe na to, I am not trying to say to an individual person. Dahil ako mismo, sabi ko nga, ako mismo, I was rebuked by this message. This message really was the answer of the Lord to that question, to that cry, to that prayer na nung nagkaroon tayo ng engagement here last time. Diba? There are people who came in the open and they said that hindi ko nararamdaman yung Holy Spirit. There were times na hindi ko nararamdaman yung Holy Spirit. And it could probably be that hindi lang isa, dalawa. It could probably that tayo din. It could probably that meron isang linggo na we come to the church and bakit kaya parang it's burdensome? Bakit kaya parang hindi ko naramdaman? Bakit kaya hindi ko na-enjoy? That is not to say sa mga tao na nandyan kasi yung the praise and worship is very powerful, the praise and worship is sound, pero bakit kaya hindi ko naramdaman? Bakit kaya parang ang layo ng Holy Spirit? So my dear brothers and sisters, this message is not for a particular or a specific person. If you feel that the Holy Spirit is convicting you, then glory to God in the highest. Amen. Then glory to God in the highest. I myself was rebuked by this message firsthand. I myself learned from this message firsthand, my dear brothers and sisters. Amen po. If the Lord rebuke us, our response should be glory to God in the highest kasi the Lord wants to teach us. The Lord wants to train us. The Lord wants us to reconsider. Amen po mga kapatid. Amen. Hallelujah. So the Lord said that my house shall be called a house of prayer but there is a misuse because you treat it as otherwise. Sabi niya rito. In 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 19, the word of the Lord said, do you not know that your bodies are the temple of the Holy Spirit, who is in you, whom you have received from God? You are not your own. Amen. So it alongside parallel sa exhortation kanina na when we say the church, we just do not mean this, but we mean yung buhay din natin. We mean this as well. So when we mean a house of worship, when we mean a place of worship, when we mean a temple, we mean this firsthand, our heart, our life, and we mean this place where we gather. Amen po. Kaya nga sabi ng Panginoon, do you not know that your bodies are the temple of the Holy Spirit? What happened, mga kapatid, when 2 Corinthians 5:17 comes? No? What happens when we, John 3:16, accepted the Lord Jesus, our personal Lord and Savior? And John 7 said that the Holy Spirit will come to you. Diba? When we became Christian, when we received the Lord Jesus as our personal Lord and Savior, the Holy Spirit indwelt us. Yung Holy Spirit po dumating sa atin. And that can only be made possible by 2 Corinthians 5:17. When it says, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, that you are a brand new creation. That is the power of salvation, mga kapatid, na nung humiling tayo ng kapatawaran ng Panginoon, when we receive the Lord Jesus as our personal Lord and Savior, kaya nga nandun yung sinasabing, pinatawad tayo. Nilinis tayo ng Panginoon. Amen. Yun naman yung natanggap natin when we were saved, when we received the Lord Jesus. Alam natin na makasalanan tayo, but when we accepted the Lord Jesus as our personal Lord and Savior, ano yung nangyayari sa atin? Napapatawad po tayo, nililinis po ang ating kasalanan. Amen. Bilang napatawad, bilang nilinis na isang tao, dyan pumapasok yung 2 Corinthians 5:17 that we are a brand new creation. Dahil bakit, mga kapatid? The old has gone, the new has come. Bakit? Dahil yan lang yung tanging paraan in order for the Holy Spirit to come. Amen. Yan lang po yung tanging paraan in order for the Holy Spirit to come and live with you. Kasi if you say na tinanggap ko ang Panginoon, pero hindi ka napatawad, hindi ka nalinis, hindi ka nabago, the Holy Spirit cannot come. Amen, church. 2 Corinthians 5:17, it is what makes us able to receive the Holy Spirit. Kaya ngayon sabi niya nung tinanggap na natin ang Panginoon, 1 Corinthians 6:19, that our bodies, yung binago na ng 2 Corinthians 5:17, naging templo na ng Holy Spirit. Naging host na ng Holy Spirit. Amen, church. So for today's message, sabi ko nga, when we mean the temple, when we mean the place of worship, when we mean the house of worship, when we mean the house of God, the house of the Holy Spirit, we mean first and foremost this, ang ating puso, ang ating buhay, and we mean this, kung saan po tayo nag-gather-gather. Amen po. Amen, church. Are we in agreement to that? Amen. So going back dyan sa atin, when Jesus Christ clean up the temple because there is misuse, sabi nga natin. Amen. Ngayon, the question now is, the burden of the question now lies unto us. How about us in here? How about us in here? How about in our heart? How about in our life? Is there a misuse? How about in here? This place of worship where we gather. Is there a misuse, my dear brothers and sisters? Again, that requires an individual dealing with the Lord. Kayo lamang po ang nakakaalam. Kayo lamang po ang nakakaalam. Amen. Sabi nga natin, have you ever felt coming to our place of worship? Coming to worship and as if the Holy Spirit is not there? Come on, be truthful. Honesty is the best policy, sabi nga niya dun. And when that happens, it does not bring a good feeling. That happens, it does not bring a good experience. You know, it's the same as you visited someone in their home. Although the katulong, although the son, the daughter, although the kapatid welcome you, allow you to come in, but the owner of the house does not face you. Alam mo yung bibisita ka? E yung bibisitahin mo, nasa kwarto, ayaw kang babain. Diba? Parang, it does not feel welcoming. It does not feel warm. Amen po, mga kapatid. Amen? Yung bibisita ka, bumiyahi ka pa ng malayo, para lang, kumatok ka sa pintuan, sabi, naki-schedule ka. Mars, Pars, brother, sister, pwede bang puntahan kita ng alas 10? Pumunta ka doon, yung anak yung bumukas, at sabihin sa'yo, ay, wala po siya, umalis siya kanina, 10-15 minutes ago. Diba yung ibig niyang sabihin nun? Ayaw kanyang harapin. Amen po, mga kapatid. And just imagine po, just imagine that we come to the house of worship. We come to the house of the Lord. We want to come and experience and encounter the Lord and meet the owner who is no other than the Holy Spirit. But He is not home. He does not want to meet with you. He does not want to spend time with you. Why? Because there is a misuse. Actually, yung devotion ni Cherry, I encountered that devotion as well. Yun yung ibinigay ko sa Panginoon na, Lord, sabi ko, Panginoon, John 16:24, di ba sabi mo, up until now, you have not asked anything in my name? Di ba sabi mo, Panginoon, ask anything in my name so that your joy will be complete? Is it not what we are doing, church? Amen. Pero kung titignan kasi natin dito, mga kapatid, yung concept ng asking is more than just sabihin na, Panginoon, we desire you. Panginoon, we want you to come in our service. Panginoon, pumasok ka. Panginoon, kumilos ka. Panginoon, manahan ka. It is more than that, mga kapatid. Imagine, yung isang kaibigan, dahil, let's say may problema ka, and wala kang matuluyan, wala kang matulungan, and yung isang kaibigan, sabi niya sa'yo, I feel for you. You are welcome in my home. Punta ka sa, doon ka muna sa aming tahanan. Sabi niya. And, pumunta ka nga sa kanilang tahanan. You are already sa kanilang tahanan. Nightfall comes and andun na hindi mo alam kung saan kaya ako matutulog, saan kaya ako patutulugin. Walang nakahandang space, walang nakahandang kama, walang nakahandang tutulugan. Gumagabi na, walang ihinahandang pagkain. Mga kapatid, the same way na when we desire na Holy Spirit come, mga kapatid, we need to prepare kung saan natin i-host yung Holy Spirit. We need to prepare. Ipakita natin, di ba? For that example, ano po yung example na yung in-invite mo na kaibigan sa bahay mo truly is welcome. Truly is na you mean what you say. Di ba? Padating pa lang, nilinis mo na yung bedroom. Padating pa lang, nilabhan mo na yung mga kumot, nilabhan mo na yung mga punda, inayos mo na. Amen. Padating pa lang, nakapagluto ka na, nakapagayos ka na. My dear brothers and sisters, pagpasok nung inimbita mo na yan, even with less word, mararamdaman niya yung feeling welcome. Amen. Mararamdaman. And the same with the Holy Spirit. Matthew 15:8 says that, these people honor me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. Holy Spirit, come! Holy Spirit, we need you. Holy Spirit, come to our worship, come to our service. Pero, we are not ready to host. Yes, there is no question. When we welcome the Holy Spirit will come. But the problem is our heart ready to host? Are we ready to host? Amen po, mga kapatid. Amen. It is very powerful. Na up until now, you have not asked anything in my name. But asking anything in His name, mga kapatid, is kailangan din nating ihanda, iprepara kung saan siya darating, kung saan siya papasok, kung saan siya mananahan. Amen po, church. Ephesians 4:30, it says in here, do not grieve the Holy Spirit with whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. Diba sabi na natin kanina, 1 Corinthians 16:19, the Holy Spirit came to us when we were saved. Ngayon sabi niya sa Ephesians 4:30, that Holy Spirit that came to you when you were saved, ano yung sabi niya doon mga kapatid? Do not grieve Him. The Holy Spirit can be grieved. The Holy Spirit is sensitive. The Holy Spirit is gentle. Kung gaano ka-sensitive ang iyong brother, kung gaano ka-sensitive ang iyong sister, na ingat ka kung papaano makidil sa kanila, the Holy Spirit is sensitive. The Holy Spirit is very gentle. Sabi niya doon, literally, the Holy Spirit descended to Jesus like a dove. Makita mo, may mga dove dyan. Lapitan mo pa lang, lumilipad na. Not unless siguro yung mga dove sa Farnborough na busog na sa kakakain, hindi na sila makatakbo, hindi na siguro sila makalipad. Amen. May mga dove sa Farnborough Town Center na nagkalat doon. Amen. So sabi niya doon, the Holy Spirit is sensitive. The Holy Spirit is very gentle. And He can be grieved. Ano po yung grieved na sinasabi natin dito? He can become sorrowful. Amen po. He can become hurt. He can feel that intense sorrow. And sabi niya doon, by how, mga kapatid? How do we grieve the Holy Spirit? Where is the Holy Spirit? In us and around us. And how do we grieve the Holy Spirit, mga kapatid? By the misuse of that temple, our heart, and misuse of that temple, our dwelling place, mga kapatid. And what is the danger of the Holy Spirit being grieved? Anyone po? What is the danger of Holy Spirit being grieved? The Holy Spirit may depart. The Holy Spirit may depart. You receive the Holy Spirit, but when you grieve the Holy Spirit can depart from you. The Holy Spirit can depart from us, mga kapatid. Amen. 1 Samuel 16:14, it says in there, when Saul rebelled against the Lord, when King Saul sinned against the Lord, it says in here, the Spirit of the Lord departed from Saul, and an spirit of the Lord, an evil spirit from the Lord troubled him. Amen. The Holy Spirit departed from King Saul, and he allowed an evil spirit to torment him, mga kapatid. Amen. So we don't want to grieve the Holy Spirit. Huwag nating i-grieve ang Holy Spirit by the misuse that we apply, by the misuse that we commit in here, in our heart, in our life as a believer, and in here, in the church where we come and gather. Mga kapatid, what are the things that we do that grieve the Holy Spirit? Number one on top of our list, what is that? Sin. Sin. Yun po yung number one, mga kapatid. Kaya nga po, ang pangalan niya ay Holy Spirit dahil siya ay holy. Ngayon, if there is a sin, sin and holiness cannot coexist. Amen po. Kaya, what grieved the Holy Spirit is sin. As Jesus is without no sin, the Holy Spirit is called the Holy Spirit of Jesus. So the Holy Spirit as well has no sin. Kaya po Holy Spirit ang kanyang pangalan. Amen. Ephesians chapter 4 verses 25 to 32. Ito po. Ano yung sabi niya rito mga kapatid? Ephesians chapter 4 verse 25 to 32. Therefore each of you must put off falsehood and speak truthfully to his neighbor. So yung pagsisinungaling po, ano? For we are all members of one body. In your anger, do not sin. Again, sabi nga natin, anger is a natural human out, ano yung natural human normal sa isang tao. But ano yung sabi niya doon? In your anger, do not sin. Amen. Hallelujah. Do not let the sun go down while you are still angry. And do not give the devil a foothold, for he has been stealing. He who has been stealing must steal no longer. So, maraming klase po yung pagnanakaw, ano? Sometimes, sabi ng Panginoon, even in our tithes and offering, we steal against the Lord. But must work, doing something useful with his own hand, that he may have something to share with those in need. Do not let unwholesome talk come out of your mouths. Ay, mga may PhD tayo dyan sa mga chisem, di po ba? But only what is helpful for building others up according to their needs, that it may benefit those who listen. Pay attention mga kapatid, dahil kumbaga, these are all practical applications. And do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God with whom you were sealed for the day of redemption. Get rid of all bitterness, rage and anger, brawling and slander, along with every form of malice. Lahat ng bagay na may malisya. Be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, just as Christ forgive us. So mga kapatid, no? Let's distant ourselves from sin. Dahil sin can grieve the Holy Spirit. Number two, mga kapatid, what does grieve the Holy Spirit is disobedience and rebellion. Alam natin, di ba mga kapatid, that when King Saul disobeyed and rebelled against the Lord, ano yung sabi ni King Saul? Does the Lord delight in burnt offerings? That the Lord delight in sacrifice more than obedience? Because alam natin mga kapatid na the root cause of all sin is disobedience. Amen. Nagnakaw ka? That is a sin of pagnanakaw. But before that becomes a sin of pagnanakaw, that is a sin of disobedience. Kasi ang sabi ng Panginoon, huwag kang magnakaw. The root cause of all sin is disobedience. Maski yung sinasabi nating generational sin, it's because of disobedience of Adam and Eve. Amen. And when you say disobedience, you are rebelling against the will of God. And the Lord sees rebellion as one of the sin that talagang detestable sa Kanya. Amen po. And when we say disobedience, we just do not mean yung salita ng Panginoon na nakapaloob dyan. Disobedience means as well, mga kapatid, is being disobedience to, I mean even, to be honest, even it's scriptural to the authority that He created. Because sabi niya dun sa Romans 13, 1 and 2, let everyone be subject to governing authorities, for there is no authority except that which God has established. The authority that exists have been established by God. Consequently, he who rebels against the authority is rebelling against what God has instituted, and for those who will bring judgment for themselves. I do not support the president na yung presidente ngayon, 'di ba sa Pilipinas? Ay, yung presidente ngayon, hindi maka ganito akong kulay, maka ganun akong kulay. But my dear brothers and sisters, however evil that president is, it was God who allowed them to be there for a purpose. Even Putin, the Lord put Putin there for a purpose. And we know and we do believe that the war in Ukraine, the Lord's will and time frame and purpose is being fulfilled, my dear brothers and sisters. Amen. And for our information, there are only three authorities that the Lord consecrated. If you look at the Bible, there are only three authorities. Number one, the government. Not just the physical government, but every place that there is a governance. At work, there is a governance. So gaano man yung manager nyo, how do you call the boss, yung employer nyo, you have to obey them. You have to be subjected to them. At home, mga bata, gaano man kayo mayroong discrepancies, differences with your parents, the Lord put them there as the authority in your household. So even dumating yung time na you have learned all the learning, you have learned all the studies in the world, na marami na kayong napatunayan, andun pa rin na every parents is, maski marami ka nang napatunayan, yung desire, yung prayer ng parents is for you to obey them. Maski meron na kayong sariling mga anak, you have to continue to obey your parents. Amen. And the thirdly is in the church, mga kapatid. So whatever it is, mga kapatid, gaano man kasama yung pastor, gaano man hindi nyo gusto yung pastor, yung mga tumatayo, yung naglilid, mga kapatid, andyan pa rin. Not unless the Lord take them away. If they do not walk in the will of the Lord, believe me, it will be the Lord that will take them away. So if you disobey and rebel, mga kapatid, the Holy Spirit will depart. Number three, unbelief. Amen. James 1:6-8, but let him ask in faith with no doubting, for he who doubts is like a wave of sea driven and tossed by the winds. For let that not man suppose that he will receive anything from the Lord. For he is a double-minded, unstable in all his ways. Hebrews 11:6, and without faith, nothing. It is impossible to please God. Amen. So if you have unbelief, kung hindi ka nananampalataya, kung hindi ka naniniwala, the Holy Spirit will not even depart. He will not come in the first place. Amen, mga kapatid. So the encouragement of Jesus Christ for us is for us to have a great faith. And what does Jesus mean when great faith? Remember the disciple, a lot of time that Jesus rebuked them. You, O little faith, why is that? Because although they have that great faith, pero di ba may unbelief sila? Peter, he started to walk in the waters and he was able to do a couple of steps. Pero when he was distracted, unbelief came. And he began to sink. And Jesus said, you, O little faith. So ang encouragement ng Panginoon sa atin, mga kapatid, is have a great faith. And the Bible's definition of great faith is that little faith as big as the mustard seed without doubt, without unbelief. That is the great faith. Number four, mga kapatid, that allows the Holy Spirit to depart from us is departing from the truth. Departing from the truth. Iba po, mga kapatid, yung hindi ka nanampalataya sa Panginoon, Because sabi nga natin, the Holy Spirit will not come in the first place. But departing from the truth, meaning you have walked in the truth, meaning nanampalataya ka, meaning nakilala mo ang Panginoon, meaning natanggap mo ang Holy Spirit, pero bakit kaya lumilihis ka? Bakit kaya nanlalamig ka? Bakit kaya nagbabackslide ka? Mga kapatid, ano yung napag-aralan natin na yung big revelation natin recently, Hebrews 6:4? It is impossible for those who have been once enlightened, who have tasted the heavenly gift, who have shared in the Holy Spirit, who have tasted the goodness of the Word of God in the powers of the coming age, and they fall away. It will be impossible, it will be difficult for them to be brought back again to repentance. Because through their loss, they keep on crucifying our Lord Jesus Christ. They keep on subjecting the Lord in that public disgrace, mga kapatid. By the word, public disgrace. When you depart from the truth, mga kapatid, what is the truth? The grace of the Lord. When you depart from the truth, the Holy Spirit does not only depart from you, but you depart from the grace of the Lord. The grace of the Lord, na yun lang yung dahilan kung bakit tayo saved, mga kapatid. Amen? Number five, why does the Holy Spirit depart from us mixing with the world? 1 John 2:15, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. Amen? Let us separate from the world. 2 Corinthians 6:14, do not be unequally yoked together with the unbelievers. For what fellowship has righteousness with lawlessness? And what communion has light with darkness? And what accord has Christ with Belial? All what part has a believer with the unbeliever? And what agreement with the temple of God with idols? Mga kapatid, the kingdom of God and the kingdom of world does not mix up together. Let us not, eto mga kapatid, no? Especially sa mga nagli-lead ng music team, no? Especially sa mga nagli-lead ng music team or yung mga tayo nagli-lead ng music team. Mga kapatid, if you lead that praise and worship, I believe that you can agree with me. If you do not agree with me, please disagree and please point it out that, Pastor, I think I disagree with that. I think hindi ganyan. There is a posture. May posture po ang pagli-lead ng praise and worship. And there is that posture of that worldly concert. There is a posture of leading a praise and worship and a posture of worldly worship. Let should not mix together, mga kapatid. Huwag tayong mag-mix, especially kung ang basihan natin, internet, YouTube. And makikita natin, bakit kaya lalo na yung mga famous ano ngayon, no? I mean, I'm happy to call it out. Makikita natin yung mga Bethel, makikita natin yung mga Hillsong na yan. And when they, yung pinapakita nila na yun, it's for commercial. It's for the viewership, mga kapatid. Amen. Yung mga posture nila dun na kwan, even if appealing sa mata, it needs to be appealing sa mata. You do not have to follow or mimic those. By all means, kung meron kang personal, mayroon kang personal conviction and revelation from the Lord, then by all means, do it. But if you do that dahil lang sa nakita mo dun, it's not. I had a discussion with someone before na pagka sa praise and worship dahil nakita doon na umiikot yung mga tao na nagli-lead, pumupunta sa mga tao, pwede rin nating gawin yun. Mga kapatid, ang dami nila doon. Kung gagawin mo dito sa maliit na kwan and paikot-ikot ka dyan, it's going to be a disturbance. Hindi dapat kung ano yung nakikita natin sa mundo, we should not adopt it. And you know, this grieved the Lord. This grieved the Lord. And sabi ko nga, kung gawa-gawa ko lang ito, let the Lord deal with me personally. Over the next few weeks, kung may marinig kayo na, ay, nangyari kay Pastor ito, it is because nagsinungaling ako in this pulpit. Umiyak ang Panginoon in few occasions. Why? This is what we do sometimes. Especially, pag nagkaroon tayo ng maganda, nagkaroon tayo ng powerful na worship. What the music team does is sa harap, well done, appear, shake hands, good one, well done. Mga kapatid, that grieved the Lord. If you look at the book of Acts, the last time na may gumawa niyan, when King Herod was talking and people came and, well done, King Herod died there and then. Hindi lang siya namatay there and then, uod lumabas sa kanyang katawan. By why? Because what? Kasi sabi ng Biblia, lahat ng meron tayo, we cannot do anything without the Lord. Kaya lahat ibalik natin sa Panginoon. Amen. Kaya lahat ibalik natin sa Panginoon. Let's acknowledge na iano natin, well done, maraming salamat Panginoon sa buhay nito. Maraming salamat Panginoon sa buhay ng ganito. And it grieved the Lord. It grieved the Lord. So mga kapatid, let us not mix with the world. Amen po. Amen. Number 6 is repentance. This is the only way that is keeping the Holy Spirit in us and within us. Regardless na andyan yung sin natin, andyan yung disobedience in rebellion natin, andyan yung unbelief natin, andyan yung departing from the truth, andyan yung sometimes there is that mixing with the world. Pero mga kapatid, yung last stance is repentance. Amen. Repentance po. Repentance is the only key that keeps the Holy Spirit in us. Repentance is the only key that makes the Holy Spirit not depart from us. The Holy Spirit is waiting for us to stop sinning. The Holy Spirit is waiting for us to repent and come back to Him. Amen. The problem ngayon, mga kapatid, is if we harden our heart. The problem, mga kapatid, is if we do not repent, even after the Holy Spirit is convicting us, mga kapatid, ano po yung mangyayari dun? We will continue to live distant in sin until we perish. Yun po yung mangyayari dun, mga kapatid. Like what happened to King Saul. Walang repentance, he continue to live away from the Lord until during that time, mga kapatid, na dumating yung kanyang oras. So mga kapatid, it's very real when the Holy Spirit depart from us. In here, sa ating temple, and in here, sa ating temple. Because of the misuse that we apply. Sabi nga natin kanina, 1 Samuel 6:14, the Spirit of the Lord departed from Saul. Amen. Jude 16:20, Samson, the Spirit of the Lord departed from Samson. Samson is not meant to drink alcohol. Samson is not meant to cut his hair. But dahil may misuse, sabihin na natin mga kapatid na it was not Samson who cut his hair. It was Delilah. But even so, he allowed himself. And because there is a misuse, Judge 16:20, it says in here that the Lord left Samson. Psalms 51:11, the prayer of David is, do not banish me from your presence. do not take away your Holy Spirit from me. So it is very clear, it is very true, mga kapatid. If we are sitting in there and we are not convinced na the Holy Spirit can depart from us in here and in this place, mga kapatid, hindi po magsisinungaling ang Panginoon. Amen. Amen, church. Hallelujah. Exodus 3:5. It says in here, when God called to Moses from the burning bush, the first thing God told him was, remove your sandals, for your the ground that you're standing is a holy ground. Amen. When the Lord called Moses to the burning bush, yun po yung unang sinabi niya kay Moses, remove your sandal, take off your sandal because the ground that you are standing is a holy ground. Amen. Fast forward, some 40 years later, when Joshua and the people of Israel coming out from Jordan and they are standing to conquer Jericho. And when Joshua was standing there, the army of the Lord showed himself to him. And when Joshua bowed down, what did the angel told to Joshua? Take off your sandal because the ground that you're standing is a holy ground. It is the same instruction that the Lord gave to Moses. It is the same instruction that the Lord gave to Joshua. And it is the same instruction that Jesus did in the temple. He cleansed the temple because it is a holy place and it is being misused, mga kapatid. Amen po? Hebrews 13:8, Jesus Christ, God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. It is the same God who told Moses to remove your sandal, the same God who told Joshua to remove your sandal. It is the same God that allowed Jesus to operate to cleanse the temple, mga kapatid. Amen? So what is the purpose of God? Ano kaya yung purpose ng Panginoon sa mga incident na to? How does it relate to us here, mga kapatid, people of God? How does it relate to us? Clearly, merong correlation po. Clearly, there is a correlation. And what is the call of the Lord? Remove your sandal. Because the ground that you're standing is a holy ground. The ground, mga kapatid, that we are standing, this place of worship, this temple of God, both here and then here, mga kapatid, comes holy because of His presence. Where two or three are gathered in my name, there I am in the midst of them. And because He is in their midst becomes holy. Amen, church. Hallelujah. The ground that we are standing, this place, other people called it number 8, Alton Scout Hall. But for us, we call this our worship place. For us, we call it, this is our place of worship. For us, we call it, this is a house of worship. And mga kapatid, we need to take our sandals off because this is a holy ground. Amen. What does taking our sandals off? Getting rid of our sin as well as anything that does not bring glory to Him. Amen po. Anything that can defile this and this po. Amen po. 1 Peter 1:14-16, it says in there, you must live as God's obedient children. Do not slip back in your old ways of living to satisfy your own desires. You didn't know any better then, but he who called you is holy. You also be holy in your conduct. It is written, be holy because I am holy. Amen. So let us be holy in here, in our heart, and in here, in the place where he calls us into, mga kapatid. Taking our sandals, mga kapatid, is a sign of reverence. Taking our sandal is a sign of respect. Is a sign of solemnity and a sign of humility. Is a sign na sinasabi nating, Panginoon, we are nothing and you are everything. It's a sign na sinasabi nating, Panginoon, we are not standing in level of you. Panginoon, we are not standing in level of you. Our place, Panginoon, is in your feet. But for a Christian, the word of the Lord says, there is no highest calling than to offer worship at the feet of the Lord. Amen. So if you believe that you are at the feet of the Lord, you are actually most blessed because the Bible says, whoever are the lowest will become the greatest in the kingdom of heaven. Amen po. So mga kapatid, another misuse. Let us not desire standing next to the Lord. Let's desire being in the feet of the Lord. Hallelujah. It is a sign that we respect the Lord. It is the sign that we revere the Lord. In mga kapatid, we need to observe, we need to maintain, we need to actively work out to preserve the holiness and sanctity of the place of worship, both in our heart and both in this place. Amen po. In our service, maski kaninong bahay tayo nag-gather during the week. Amen. This is the burden, mga kapatid, na kailangan na nating i-address. This is the burden na kailangan na nating i-address. This is, I don't know if you call yung the saying na this is the elephant in the room that we need to address, mga kapatid. We need to begin to treat the worship place of the Lord with solemnity and sanctity, both dito sa ating puso and both itong tahanan ng Panginoon. Amen. With this, can I speak to all the women's po later on, although marami pong wala, pero if I wanna speak with the women's po later on and then we will disseminate, cascade it as well sa ating mga kapatid na wala dito. Amen po. So mga kapatid, we need to start observing and maintaining and actively working out to preserve the holiness and sanctity of our worship, our service, both in here and in here, mga kapatid. Otherwise, the Holy Spirit, the Lord will depart from us. Amen po. Romans 12, 1 and 2. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve that God's will is His good, pleasing, and perfect will. Amen po. So, let us not treat the Lord with contempt. Let us not be familiar with the Lord na nawawala yung pagrespeto natin sa Panginoon sa kanyang tahanan. Amen. This is the reason po, mga kapatid. No? This is the reason po, mga kapatid, na to the music team, we encourage you to be here at 10 o'clock and all the rest na gagamitin na tatayo, we encourage you here to be here at 10:15 para po sanctification. What is the purpose of that sanctification? My switch. We are walking in the world. We are coming to a holy ground. At magkaroon tayo that moment, mga kapatid, to take off those sandals. It's all about spiritual sanctification. Sabi ko nga, Pastor, pag bumibiyahe po kami papunta rito sa sasakyan pa lang, we ready ourselves, we ask for the Lord's forgiveness. Yeah, you do that personally. But you come corporately as a minister na tatayo. We need to have that sanctification for the Lord as well. Do you believe, mga kapatid, na there is no growth without sacrifice? Amen. There is no growth without sacrifice. Alam natin na we want to grow both here and here, but it demands sacrifice po. Amen. If you are offering a gift at the altar, then remember that your brother has something against you. Leave your gift and go first, be reconciled to your brother, and then come and offer your gift. Diba? Napaka-importante na we reconcile with our brothers and sisters. Pero ano po yung mas importante doon? Ano po yung mas importante doon? We reconcile with the Lord. Diba? We reconcile with the Lord. That's the reason why na before we come and offer our gifts in here, na nagkakaroon tayo ng sanctification to be reconciled with the Lord. Amen po. Amen, church. Let's post it in here po. Amen po. Let's continue the message of the Lord. Next Sunday, let's post it in here. And can we welcome all the music team back? Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Praise you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Sige, let's stand up po mga kapatid. And let us declare that the God of revival, that the God of revival is in this place. That the God of revival is with us. And sabi nga niya doon, for the purpose of reviving us. And revival means, mga kapatid, is breathing that breath of life again. Di ba, pag nagsi-CPR tayo, na we revive that person na nagsi-CPR natin, we need to give that rescue breath, the breath of life na binigay ng Panginoon sa atin. No? Sabi niya sa Genesis, we only became a living being when God gave His breath of life upon us. So, once again, let us desire that Holy Spirit. Sabi nga niya kanina sa John 16:24 na this is the perfect time. This is the right time to ask the Holy Spirit to come to us again. If we have not yet been asking that before, this is the time to ask the Holy Spirit to breathe Himself to us again. But natutunan din natin that we have the duty to sanctify. We have the duty to be desired to be sanctified, na magpalinis upang sa ganun the Holy Spirit can truly dwell and come to us. Amen po. Hallelujah. Thank you. Until now, you have not any asked anything in my name. Ask and you will receive, so that your joy will be complete. It is more than a song, my dear brothers and sisters. Let us desire it according to the word. We are not yet in that level where we desire. We are not yet in that level where we say, Lord Spirit, touch your church. Let us desire it. There is a reason why the Lord says, up until now, you have not asked anything in my name. But the Lord said, this is the time that you need to ask so that your joy will be complete. So my dear brothers and sisters, with all conviction, with unity, with a contrite heart, it is more than a song, it is more than a lyrics. Let us desire it. Let us desire it. Hilingin natin sa Panginoon. Let's ask it on the Lord. Let's ask it to the Lord. Iiyak natin sa Panginoon. Umiyak tayo sa Panginoon. Spirit, touch your church. Let's ask the Lord, church. Let's decide it. Kapatid, receive it in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. awakening. There is going to be a great awakening in these people. Hallelujah. 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 Lord, right here, right now, we are asking this in your name. Right here, right now, we are asking this in your name. Lord, whatever it is, anything and everything that we have done to alienate you, anything and everything that we have done in this temple, our heart, in this temple, the place that we gather, any misuse that we have committed, Lord, forgive us. Forgive us, Father God. Forgive us, Lord. Forgive us, Father God. Patawarin mo po kami, Panginoon. Buong puso kaming nagpapakumbaba at humihingi ng kapatawaran mo, Lord. And Lord, right here, right now, we are asking this in your name. And we pray that we will receive this. And we pray that our joy will be complete. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Paki-flash nga po yung song. And let us not sing it, but let us offer it as a prayer. Sige, let's pray this to the Lord with all conviction and humility and humbleness. Everyone, let's pray this. Spirit, touch your church. Steer the hearts of men. Revive us, O Lord, with your passion once again, Panginoon. I want to care, O God, for others like Jesus, you have cared for me. Let your rain fall upon me, upon this heart and upon this place right now. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We receive it. We receive it. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 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 Sige, tuloy-tuloy lang po natin. Hallelujah.